All right, thank you. Good morning, how's everyone doing? Good, very good. I'm gonna make sure my microphone is okay, fine. Welcome to the show. My name is Scott. We're gonna do a little bit of magic, a little bit of juggling. Some of you are gonna get to come on up here and help me out during the show. So this year's summer reading theme is libraries rock, and that's a great theme for me because I use lots of music throughout my show, and you're gonna see some of my favorite music pieces. So one of the ways that I find new music to use for my shows is I use a radio, and I turn it on usually in my car, but I turn the radio on and see if I can find some good music. Let's see if we can do that now. That's silly. We'll see what else we have. What the frog say? Have a good rest of the morning. Thank you. We'll do some more. All right, everyone, raise one hand up in the air just like this. Raise one hand up. Very good. Put your other hand down beneath it just like this. Excellent. Everyone switch. Good. Switch back. Does everyone see this great big bunch of air right here between your two hands? Okay, good. We're going to take this great big bunch of air. We're going to make it disappear. Ooh, scary. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Good. Practice makes perfect. One more time. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Good. Practice. Thank you very much. Practice throughout the show. You might be so good that by the end of the show, you'll actually be able to do it standing. Really nice. Okay, good. Here we go. Music. Thank you. Sit down. Okay. I need some help. I need someone to come on up here and help me out. Your hand shot up so fast. You're sitting right up front. You have an American flag on your shirt. Come right on up here and help me out. Okay, very good. Stand right on over here. Face the audience. Hi, what's your name? Ever give Madison a big round of applause for coming on up here to help me out? Madison, we're going to do something together called mind reading. Do you know what mind reading is? No, okay. Well, here's what's going to happen. You're going to choose something. You're going to choose one of these cards, all right? They're all different. I don't know which card you're going to choose. The audience won't know which card you've chosen. You're going to be the only person in this whole room that knows what card you're holding on to. And I'm going to try to figure it out by reading your mind, all right? So let's take a look at a few of the cards. These are cards that have pictures of notes on them. We have a triple beamed note right there. You might choose that one. That's a half note, I believe. We have that one right there. They're all different. We have a red note, even some, we have a blue note. We have a chord. That's two notes played at the same time. We have a flag note. We have a banjo as well. All right, let's throw that one in for the mix. All right, could you raise one finger right in the air for me just like this? I want you just to touch the back of one of these cards. Just put your finger right onto the top of the card, and we'll move it to the top. Any card you'd like. Yeah, Ryan, put it right on the top somewhere here. Wherever you'd like. Okay, perfect. You want to go with that one? Okay, we're going to move it to the top. I'm going to give it to you. I want you to hold onto it. Don't let me see what it is. Don't let the audience see what it is. Make sure it's hidden from view. Very good. I have a marker. I have a pad of paper. All right, is it hidden? Is it hidden? Heidi, can you hug it for me like this so I really can't see it? Okay, very good. Have you taken a look at it? Okay, good. I have a marker. I have a pad of paper. I'm going to try to make a drawing of the card that you're holding onto. All right, here we go. Take one more look at it. Just look at it. All right, good. Hide it. Did you look at it? Okay, good. This is a hard one. I'm not sure. I don't know, let me see. Yeah, okay. I'm going to let the audience see me draw the rest of this here. Okay, just like that. Fill it in along there. All right, here we go. Here's what's going to happen. We're going to count to three. On the count of three, I'm going to turn around the drawing. You're going to turn around the card. The audience will see that they match, and they'll go absolutely nuts. Here we go. One, two, three. Turn it right around. Show the... I was close. That's why I was confused, because we were turning it the other way around, maybe. That way. No, that doesn't help. Alright, I think I know how to fix this. I think I know how to fix this. Show the audience, it does match. I'll take the card, give her a big, big round of applause for coming on up here to help me out. Nicely done. Good. All right. Noah ever give Noah a big, big round of applause for coming on up here to help me? Everyone, what was the color of the first scarf I put inside the tube? How about the color of the second scarf? Third one? Good. Noah, I want you to hold onto this tube. Can you cover both ends for me? Put one hand right over that end. Stretch, put one hand over that end. Make sure nothing gets in. Make sure nothing gets out. While you're holding onto the tube, I'm gonna go out here into the audience to do some magic with a couple people out there, okay? Okay, good. So Noah, while I'm out there, entertain them. You're doing a good job, Noah. Hold on to that tube. Cover both ends. Make sure nothing gets in or out. I need some help way back here. Who would like to help me out who's way back here? Stand on up. Stand right on up. Hi. What's your name? Riley, check this out. I'm going to do a trick just for you. Watch. I'll take the scarf and tie a knot right into the center of it. Riley, watch that knot. Don't take your eyes off of it. Watch. Exciting, isn't it? Not really, watch. Because the knot disappears, Riley, it's an invisible knot. Can you hold on to that for me? Good, hold on tight. Don't drop it. They're hard to find. We have Riley holding onto an invisible knot. I have Noah up here holding onto this clear tube with three scarves in it. How's it going? Good, I'll be right back. Let me go over here. We have Riley holding onto an invisible knot over here. Let's see. Stand on up, hi. What's your name? Andy, check this out. We're gonna do the same trick we did with Riley. Watch, I'll take the scarf. What's that? Riley, yes, we're gonna do the same trick we did with Andy. Watch. Don't take your eyes off of it, watch. Try. Do you wanna give it a try? Good. The knot disappears. Hold on to that for me, Andy. Hold on tight. Don't let go. We have two invisible knots out there. I have Noah up here holding onto this clear tube with three scarves in it. We're going to put this all together. Here's what will happen. I'll raise my fingers like this. One, two, three. On the count of three, I want you to take the invisible knot you're holding onto. Give it a toss. Throw it up here towards Noah. Noah will catch it and put it into the end of the tube. Can you do that for me? Okay, I'll give you a hand. You can put one hand right here in the middle of the tube, put one hand right there. That way you can let go with that hand. You can catch the invisible knot when you see it coming. Okay, now you'll figure it out. It'll be fine. You're overthinking it. Just make it nice and simple. Okay? I'll help you out if anything goes wrong. All right, don't worry. All right, Riley, get ready to throw your knot. Let's count to three. Everyone, here we go.
One, two, three.
The toss, catch it. Good. Put it into the end. Okay, good. Did it fall out? No, okay, good. All right, there's one more knot out there. Andy's holding on to it. This time, everyone will count to three in Spanish. Here we go.
Uno, dos, tres.
Give it a toss, Andy. Catch it. Good. Put it into the end. Okay, did you get it?
Yeah.
Okay, good. I don't really know either. All right, let's take a look and see what everyone's done. Round of applause. You got them both. Nice to see you. Let's see. How many of you? I know the library has some of these, but how many of you have ever had one of those books that comes with a cassette tape or a CD or an 8-track? It kind of reads the book along with you, helps you learn how to read, maybe speak another language. Have you had one of those? Yeah, oh, some of you, great. You can put your hands down, thanks. Well, I have one of those, but instead of teaching me how to read, this one teaches me how to make something. It teaches me how to make, and I have some here, balloon animals. So I'm gonna play a track and see if I can make the balloon animal to their instructions, and you can see how easy it is. Let me get it queued up with my little remote control and see if it's ready to go.
Welcome to Balloon Animals 101.
There it is.
Today, you are going to learn how to create a fabulous flower from two balloons.
A flower, all right.
When you hear this sound,
some green ones, some red ones.
That means you should be finished with the last step and ready to move on to the next step.
Okay.
Let's get started.
Right.
First, inflate a red balloon. Take a deep breath. Place the open end of the balloon in between your lips and blow all the air into the balloon. Don't worry if you can't blow the balloon up on the first try. Sometimes they get a little cold and need to be warmed up.
Cold? All right.
To make the balloon more pliable and easier to blow up, stretch the two ends between your hands.
Alright, that makes sense.
While you're doing this, be very careful not to let either end of the balloon go.
Yeah.
For obvious reasons.
Thank you. Ow.
Now that you've finished stretching the balloon,
yeah.
Try to blow it up.
Alright, here we go.
See how much easier that is? Now that your balloon is full of air, you need to tie the open end shut.
Okay.
Simply loop 1 inch of the nozzle end around the left hand index and middle fingers.
Alright.
Clasp the nozzle between these fingers.
Right.
And pull the loop off. The balloon will now be tied. We will now begin to twist the balloon to create the top portion of the flower. Although flowers in nature generally have 5 petals, our flower will have 4. So hopefully your audiences aren't sticklers for horticultural anatomy. Begin by locating the exact center of the balloon and twisting it into 2 sections.
All right. I think I can do that.
Now, tie the ends of these 2 sections together. This may seem hard at first.
Yeah, you think?
In fact, thank you. I remember when I first learned it as a young lass, I was nervous, as I'm sure you are. But as with all parts of life, familiarity breeds acceptance and sometimes contempt. Now that you've tied the 2 ends of the balloon together, twist the balloon into 2 equal sections.
Okay!
Carefully fold the 2 sections of balloon on top of each other.
All right.
You need to be very careful at this point, so using both hands, hold very tightly onto all the parts of the balloon. Otherwise, the balloon will unravel and burst. 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 Now, push the ends into the middle, causing the middles to go out to the ends.
I think I know what she means, I do. Like
good.
That. Like that.
Now twist what used to be the ends.
All right.
And are now the middles together.
Okay.
So that the middles that used to be the ends remain in the middle. And the ends that used to be the middles remain the ends. This is a little confusing,
yeah.
So I'll go over it one more time to clarify.
Okay, one more time.
Twist what used to be the ends and now the middles together. So the middles that used to be the ends remain in the middle and the ends that used to be the middles remain the ends.
I'll try something.
Congratulations, you have just finished the top of the flower.
Oh, it's just the top, all right. There's more.
Inflate a green balloon. Tie the end of the balloon shut.
Yeah, boom.
Push the end of the green balloon into the red balloon, leaving a 1-inch green stamen on top of the red petals.
Right, I guess we just kind of push it in.
If you like, and I recommend it, twist off 2 green leaves directly below the petals for a more realistic look.
Right, 2 leaves. I'll do 1 leaf here.
Congratulations. You have just completed Balloon Animals 101. And it will only take 12 years of public schooling, 4 years of college, and 5 years of grad school to become really good at it.
Thank you very much. Sorry. Let's see. I need some stuff. Love that part. I also need some help. I need someone to come on up here and help me. Oh, let's see. She's sitting way in the back. She has a planet on that's wearing headphones. Sort of thing you see every day. Come right on up here and help me out. Come right on up. Give her a big round of applause as she makes her way on up. Hi. Right here. What's your name? Hi. Elissa, I am Scott. Hold on to this bag for me just like that. Perfect. Elissa and I, we're going to show everyone here how to make something really, really cool out of balloons. Those long balloons are hard to find. You can't buy them at very many stores. They're hard to make, and the instructions are complicated. So, Elissa, you and I, we're going to show everyone here how to make something really cool out of regular old round balloons that you can get anywhere, all right? Reach inside that bag. Can you get me one of the dark-colored balloons? Anyone you'd like, just reach inside and grab one. If you try this project at home, do you have a dark-colored balloon? You do, perfect. Let me see that. Thank you so much. If you try this project at home, you're going to start with a pencil that has a nice soft eraser on the end. That way, when you take a dark-colored balloon and you put it over the eraser and you stretch it out, you're not going to poke a hole into the balloon. Elissa, there are some clear balloons in there. May I have one of those, please? Reach right in, grab one. Perfect. Thank you. Now you're going to take a clear balloon, a balloon that you can see through once you blow it up, and we'll put that over the dark-colored balloon just like that. And then we'll pull the pencil out. We're all set with the pencil, and we're all set with the balloons, too. All right, Elissa, this is the most difficult part. I now have to inflate the balloons, and I have to do that by blowing up the balloon that's on the inside. So I'm blowing up two balloons at the same time. This requires a lot of air pressure, so if you try this at home, use a bicycle pump or a balloon pump so you don't hurt your sinuses. I'm gonna use my mouth. I should be fine. Can you cup your hand for me just like this? Yeah, perfect. To be purple. Elissa, catch. Good catch. So we have a purple balloon with sort of a clear shell around it, but we're not done. I'm now going to take the nozzle of the clear balloon, I'll pull it free, and we'll blow the clear balloon up a little bit. And I'll tie that shut. Elissa, catch. So that's something that you can make at home. You can make that inner balloon any size you want. I made that one a little big, but you make it small so it bounces around in there. You can make them any color you want. You can decorate them. But Elissa, you and I, we're going to do a little bit of magic with these. Let me empty out the box. I'll get rid of the balloons and the pencil. And the... Ah! Elissa, put the balloons right inside the box for me, would you? Good. All right, let's make sure they fit all the way inside. Close the box up. I have some tape. Okay, we're going to tape it shut. And Elissa, hug the box. Perfect. So, inside of the box is a purple balloon. Outside of the purple balloon, protecting it, is a clear balloon. Outside of the clear balloon protecting it is a box. Outside of the box protecting it is Alyssa. Nothing protecting Alyssa. But she'll be okay. She'll be okay. As long as she stands very still. All right, Alyssa, are you ready? I don't know. Okay, that's a good answer. I like that answer. All right, that's good. You're fine. You're fine. You're perfect. Here we go. Alyssa, put the box right on the ground. There we go. I'll take off the tape. Alyssa, open up the box. Pull out what you find. Hold it up above your head, shake it around. Everyone give Alyssa a big, big round of applause for coming in up here to help me. Alyssa, you can tell them right back in there. Thank you so much for helping me out. You did a great job. One more big round of applause for Alyssa for coming in up here to help me. Nicely done. All right, where are we going? All right, how's it going? All right, so I have, I got a really cool routine. This is one of the very first routines that I ever choreographed to music when I was about 17 years old. I think you'll like the music. It's a little dramatic, it's a little spooky, but I think you'll like it. Here we go. That wasn't it. Let's try one more time. Thank you. do. This last trick, I wanted to show you something a little different. Something that's not really a magic trick. This is more of an exercise. This is something that magicians use to work out. This exercise is all about speed. It's about moving as quickly as possible. I do need some help. I need somebody to come on up here and help me out with this one. Oh my gosh, it's very hard to choose. Let's see, where are we going? Let's go right up front. Come on up here and help me out. Stand right on over here. Face the audience. Hi, what's your name?
Jackson.
Jackson, if you give Jackson a nice round of applause for coming on up here to help me out. Jackson, can you hold onto this cap for me just like that? Hold it in a flat hand just like that and keep it right about there. Jackson, here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna cover the bottle of water with my hand and I'm gonna turn it upside down. All right, and what I'm gonna try to do in this exercise is I'm gonna try to remove my hand from the bottom of the bottle of water. I'll take the cap from your hand and then I'll put the cap back on the bottle and I'll do all that before the water falls out. Okay, here we go. Ready to go? Okay. Nice and steady. Yeah, you're a little bit of higher volume. Did you do that? Step a little closer. Right over there. Perfect. Yeah. Too much. All right, here we go. Let's try it again. All right, I'm gonna cover the bottle of water. We'll turn it upside down. All right, are you ready? Nice and steady. This isn't going very well. All right, so let's try something different. This time, instead of doing this as fast as possible, let's do it in slow motion. Okay. You're very agreeable. All right, here we go. Ready? Before I go, thank you so much for watching. Give yourselves a big, big round of applause. Thank you for coming on this morning. So, people ask me, where do you get the ideas for the different tricks you do? And I get ideas from all sorts of different places. When I was 7 years old, I saw my very first magic show at a library. And then checking out books at the library, I learned how to juggle, and I learned how to do my very first magic tricks. And now, I use the library to look for inspiration, for new ideas for tricks. And this trick comes from a book titled The Time Machine. And in that book, the hero is a scientist who builds a time machine, and he uses it to travel 8,000 years forwards into time. And then he turns his time machine around, he returns to his own time, and he finds everything is as he left it. And I thought, wouldn't that be a cool idea for a trick? What if I could do something, maybe make a mess? And then is it going backwards through time? What if I could undo everything I had just done? So the bowl of water will be our time machine. The grains of sand, red, yellow, and blue, those grains of sand will be our time travelers. And in this little black canister here is a secret ingredient which is going to help us move through time. And because it's the library's rock, I also need a little bit of music. Thank you. Through time, and I'm going to see if I can do that by pulling the sand out of the water one color at a time, and so that the sand comes out dry. Red, yellow, blue, which color would you like to see first? Your choice. Blue. Blue comes out first. Blue comes out first. Red or yellow, what's next? Yellow. Yellow comes out next. Blue. Yellow. Next. Good choice. Blue. Yellow, red, blue comes out.
Tiana, cool.
Summer. There are more activities to follow. If you head out the doors and go into the children's room around that way, thank you so much for coming. Have a great rest of the day. Bye, guys.
Hi, my name is Kate Godwin. I'm the children's librarian for the Hanson Public Library. Today is our summer reading kickoff day. We just had a wonderful show by Scott Jameson, who is a magician, and he did a great job with the kids. There's a lot of fun things happening over the summer that I wanted to tell you a little bit about. We have some bikes that were donated by Knights of Pythias, an organization that was very generous and gave us 3 kids' bikes for girls in grades 1, 2, and 3, and then boy bikes as well. So to keep us incentive to keep reading over the summer, we have a punch card that we've been handing out to kids that every 5 hours that they read, they'll be able to come into our library and get a free book and a free prize, and then we get entered into a raffle for the bikes, as well as Treetops Adventures, which is another organization that donated a grand prize for us, and those are some grand prizes as well. So we have a lot of fun things planned this summer. We have some great art classes with Allison Andrews, who is a Hanson resident. Ages 10 and up, create a quote of art. We have Make Art Rock Guitars, another art class, painting and drawing butterflies for both ages 5 through 7 and ages 7 through 12. We have a kids yoga class and a yoga mat painting class, which is really fun. That's in August for ages 7 to 12. Rocking Tic-Tac-Toe Game, which is Wednesday, August 1st, 10 a.m. A Rock Photo Holders for ages 10 and up. Rock Star Rocks and Kindness Rocks as well. We have a couple programmings for that. To a couple Wednesday mornings in July. We also have kids' community cooking classes back this summer. We've had them in the past. They do a phenomenal job with the kids. We're going to be basing them on the children's book, If You Give a Mouse a Cookie by Laura Numeroffs, and we'll be making cookies. And then another one for If You Give a Mouse a Muffin, and we'll be baking muffins. And those are for ages 5 through 11, and we only have 15 spots for those, so those are probably sent up really quick. We also still have our Saturday Stories programming with Miss Jess. Musical craft. She's going to be doing some tambourines and shakers and maracas, microphones, things like that. So that'll be wonderful. Kristen Neely is coming to do a music class with us on Friday, July 3rd. She'll have an acoustic guitar for the little ones, and that will be a limit of 20. It's for all ages. We have family bedtime story time with me. I'm going to be dressed in my pajamas so we can come, you know, listen to some great read-alouds and do a fun bedtime craft together. And that's on July 17th and Tuesday evening at 6:45. We're also doing gemstone slime for ages 5 and up. On Thursday, July 19th, we're going to make slime and use plastic gemstones and just some things like that. We're making cupcakes with Julie for ages 6 to 9. We're going to enjoy some musical stories and make some music-themed cupcakes. That's another one that will fill up quickly, ages 6 through 9, and that's in August. We have Mama Steph coming again, who's always great. She does some wonderful music, traditional music and musical stories and sing-alongs. So that's on Friday, July 20th at 10. Ed the Wizard's coming for a rocket building workshop for ages 6 and up. We're going to learn how to build air-powered rockets and airplanes and test our skills for flight length, accuracy, turns, and stunts. And then we also have our Lego Builder Night, which we always have, and it's wonderful, and the kids can come and just join their friends and have fun building with the library's collection of Legos. Afterwards, we actually have them on display in our lobby cases out front, so the kids love to see that when they come in the library. Backyard Bugs is coming. They're actually from the Plymouth County, and they're going to be discussing exploring how insects are found in our own backyard. That'll be interesting for ages 6 to 9. On Friday, August 3rd at 10 a.m. We also have a tween book to movie club, and that's for ages 9 and up on Tuesday, August 7th from 5 to 7. You can check the book out now, read the book, A Wrinkle in Time, and then we'll actually be at meeting together to discuss the book and watch the movie together, and we'll have some snacks and some fun on that night. So as you can see, there's a lot to offer here at the library in Hanson. If you have any questions on how to set up or anything like that, we're always here to help. You can call the library or stop by, and we'll be happy to sign you up for those programs. Thanks for coming. Bye.